By the way, I saw your DJ set on your Instagram story last night. That was incredible. Was that planned?
It was planned.
Not as long as he did the full 2-hour set last night.
That's insane. Hey,
the Gen Z kids were
just, no half measures of this man. It's all in or not at all.
I think we gave him a great little party, didn't we?
Yeah,
we had a wonderful screening, great Q&A.
Yeah, really cool.
Yeah.
Amazing, amazing. Now, in the show, a big part of it is the ominous countdown that appears in front of the scientist's eyes. Mm. If the countdown appeared in front of your eyes, what would you do with your final 24 hours?
Well, it's quite handy, actually, because I'd make a really nice roast. see where the spuds are going.
I'd buy some white truffles. I'd spend the entire budget on a meal. Just sit down and weep into my bread and butter pudding.
I think we, what did we want to do? Hijack a car and just fast car and drive off?
Yeah, drive into a wall.
Okay.
It's weird. What would you do in the last 24 hours?
I thought food. I think I'll just spend all my money on burgers, pizza, pasta, the lot of it, and just cry into my spaghetti. Oh, and
I
just
think I'd go 3-star Michelin. There'll be no chef in there. He's not going to be cooking for me.
gather family and friends.
Yeah.
And
big bowl of pasta.
Big party.
At one point, the universe blinks in the show. Have you guys ever experienced anything otherworldly, like a UFO or a ghost or just something you can't explain?
Oh, I had a moment. I used to live in Avery. I didn't tell you this. No. I had a gun pulled on me when I was up the top of a mountain. I'm not even kidding you. I saw Halley's Comet 1986.
Wow.
And I'd driven up just to get away from the little town, tiny town I was living in. It was in Avery. And I was up where the radio mast was, just to get away from the lights. And I was going, I found it. I got my wife was with me, and there was a couple of other people. And I was up like that, and I heard a click, and I looked around, and there was a guy with a rifle. Clicked the gun, aimed at me. He was a guard, an army guard on the radio antenna.
Oh.
And he very difficult. He didn't speak a word of English. It was very difficult to explain to him that I was looking at a comet. It's true. It's good.
Oh my God.
There you go. He just reminded me of that.
That's crazy. Oh my goodness. Benedict, have you seen anything? Maybe not as mad as that, but...
I don't think I have, actually. Been all right.
That's good.
No aliens.
In the show, there is the three-body video game that the characters get addicted to. Is there a video game from your past that if you put it on your head, you'd just be sucked in?
Abe's Odyssey. Remember that? Do you ever play Abe's Odyssey?
No.
Me and the wife nearly fell out over there. To tear lumps out of each other while we were playing it.
What format was it on?
Was it on one of the early...
VIC 20.
Yeah, it was on an abacus.
ZX81.
Really
he had to build his own game.
Amstrad. I can't remember what platform. Is it one of the early PlayStations or something like that? Oh, that was really cool. Oh, when the N64 came out, with Mario 64, my God, that was groundbreaking. Oh, me and the wife are so happy until we had another row in the middle of that one. Yeah, we had to stop playing games. We would have killed each other.
I can't play games with my family. It just gets way too tense.
I just love playing FIFA. That's all I play since 1996. Now called FC24.
Nice, nice.
Looking forward to the paid partnership. Thank you.
Very big. Mario Kart is huge in our house. Because, you could do the four players.
And, that's great.
I remember being up the kitchen because I liked the cooking, watching a family on the sofa, all having a laugh.
Amazing.
And through the game and just kind of gone. It was a really weird, proper, gorgeous family unit moment through a video game. It's wonderful stuff. They get much maligned video games for... taking people away, but they're not. My son's a big gamer. He's really social. Mm. He's talking to all his mates all the time. They're having a laugh. They're scaring the bejesus out of each other and all sorts of stuff. It's incredibly social.
Now, Benedict, this is a bit of a throwback, but my boss will kill me if I do not ask you this question.
Okay.
You played one of his favourite characters of all time, Prime, in the IT Crowd, and he wants to know, what do you remember from shooting that episode?
Played this Morpheus character from Matrix with the Lawrence Fishburne.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I'd love to see that.
And then, actually, a bizarre thing happened to me because I've since sort of befriended with Lawrence Fishburne. I went to go visit him at his house, and I got the Uber to his place. I thought, is this the right place? And then a car drove past and went, Street Countdown!
Street Countdown!
said whatever the prime character, so I was going to the Morpheus character, and then I was just about to go meet the guy that played Morpheus.
Wow. What a coincidence.
Now, if that's not the Matrix, I don't know.
That's a glitch. That's a glitch.
Well, there you go. That's your weird thing that you saw.
That's
Well, guys, thank you so much for talking to me. Congratulations on the show. I can't wait for everyone else to see it.
Thank you.
Thanks. Nice talking to you.